So, hello guys, my name is Benz, and welcome to that video. Welcome back to the No Pain, No Gain series. So, as I said before in other live streams and previous tweets and that, the No Pain, No Gain series is going to start afresh. So, it's going to start again from scratch. Actually, I'm going to tell a lie now. I'll get to that bit in a second. But yeah, so, moved out. It's been a long time since the last video was recorded. Of the series, so I've had to update pronouns, I've had to update the game, you know, there's different things going on, so my save file was no good for it, the original save file, plus I was too out of the loop anyway to remember what I'd already done on there anyway, so starting afresh was the best idea, and that is what I've done, but no matter what I just said, I haven't started properly afresh. We're not starting from the very beginning. I've sort of got ourselves to a point where we have our own personal truck. We have a bit of debt to pay for it, but we haven't started in the same place. Whereas we started in, I think it was Reykjavik in Iceland on the other one. We're starting in Felixstowe on this one. The reason being, I started a profile just to test to make sure all the pro mods worked and everything. I spent a lot of effort setting up the controller again and setting up the buying the truck and all that, that I didn't want to start again after that to then try and find a new location. But we'll start from Felixstowe, it's not a problem. I've done a few drives on the Felixstowe Road, the A12, and we'll see some things that I really like. Like it's got my own hometown on one of the road signs, Ipswich. It's got that on there. That's really good. I really like that. The detail on pro mods is ridiculous. But anyway, this is the truck, the Avega Stralis. I'm pretty sure it's the same specs that we had last time. I can't remember. Pretty basic. So just to remind people of what the No Pain No Gain series is. It is, you put in a lot of work to get out a big reward. So I'm not going to mod in money. I'm not going to mod in anything that will help me along my way. I'll put things in to make it more realistic. So, say, I might put in another truck, but then again, I've still got to buy that truck. I can't just give it to myself. But the map is giving us lots of options. There's far more places on here than I was beforehand. I do have the Roost map mod installed, but for some reason, that's not showing up. Unless this is Rus. No, Russia's here, isn't it? Yeah, for some reason I don't have it. Oh, it goes into Spain. Oh, Barcelona. That'll be a good one to go to. Yeah, we've got loads of places to go to. We've got plenty to do. Plenty of places to see. Yeah. So I think we should crack on. We can't do external contracts because of the mods, it won't work with the mods, it won't pick places that's newer in the mods and we want to see the new places. So we're going to go with the freight market. And where am I currently? I'm closer to Arnhem. Yeah, when I was doing the test, and I think I did do one test with the Iveco. I apologize. I think I've done one test with the Iveco to go to here. So this is where we're going to start off the series from Arnhem. But our home base, the home garage, is in Felixstowe. Excuse me. So what can we do here then? So to start off with, we need to make the biggest amount of money. GBM Douglas. Where the hell is that? Ah, the Isle of Man. I haven't been there yet at all. Where do we go in through? Where is that? Newcastle. So we're going through Newcastle. Let's do that one. That's gonna be an interesting one. What weight is it? 8 ton. So the Ivigo should piss all over it really. So yeah, let's do that. So we've got through here, up through Ismuiden, and then up, and then into there. Let's do that. So let's try that. That's gonna give us a newer look at a newer part of the pro mods straight off from the first video. Right, set as destination. Oh, hello. Straight into the game. No fanning about. Right, so here's the truck. I'm pretty sure it's the same. I've got nothing really inside. I've got the sat nav, which I said I'd have beforehand, because that helps a lot. I mean, we've got to have this stupid map up all the time. Let's get rid of that. Right. So, let's crack on. So, Arnhem, I do believe. I can't remember to look at the traffic on this. Oh no, I need to go this way. My bad. And this Arnhem is a whole new bit of the map on Pro Mods. Yeah, I can't remember to look at the traffic. I keep forgetting I'm not on multiplayer anymore. And the map doesn't tell me where people are. I was going to look to the left of me sat nav. So I'll get back, back into all those habits again. Yeah, Reykjavik, the snow, we'll eventually get back to that. A lot of people enjoyed the snow. A lot of people asked questions, where'd the snow come from? But we will get back to that. So yeah, how has everyone been? People who haven't seen the house tour video and haven't realised what I'm doing and where I am or where I've been, I have moved into my own house. That's why you can see a completely different backdrop. And that is why videos and live streams should all come thick and fast to your lovely, lovely faces. Straight on the fucking motorway, straight up again. Ooh, get through there before they change. Oh yeah, so I'm now officially back. I've now recorded my first video since being back. Done a few live streams, but that's not properly being back till you start doing your videos. So this is my first video being back on YouTube. Ah, you've got nothing, and I pick up a trailer. We used to do external contracts as well. So I forget about all this stuff. So it's a Douglas. So can we change it? Blue or red? We'll stick with blue. Tech job. Why don't I take that one? Let's take that. Right, hold on a second. Do I have advanced trailer mode mods on? Advanced trailer coupling. If I do, that's a problem. No, I don't. So why isn't that picking that trailer up? What's going on here? Oh, because it's not advanced, is it? If not advanced, you've got to press the T button to get it, to clip the trailer. My bad.
Right.
Anyway, so, quickly, yeah. Videos will be back. Thick and fast. It's going to be every other day, I believe. I've got to try to do it every other, believe. Every other day, I'm not going to be able to do it straight off because of... I'm busy. I'm doing things around the house as well. Still quite a bit of work to be doing around the house. But I am back. The videos are back. Live stream I'm going to try and do every single day. I'm going to try and do a little live stream after this video. After I recorded this. Because that allow the every other day. So one day I'll do recording, one day I'll do editing. And I'm gonna try and mix it up with a few other games. Like I know, like Star Citizen. I made a couple of videos on that on live streams, I think. But that's been updated. And hopefully they fixed one of the issues that I had with it, with the was the lag. And that wasn't, I don't think that was a PC performance lag, that was a that was like a server lag. And they've now localized the servers, so there'll be a European server, there'll be an American server, yada yada, instead of having everyone on the same server. So it should free it up a bit, make it a bit less laggy, and it should be a bit more interesting to play with. I love these Promons maps. They're just so more realistic. I'm also going to be looking to do collaborations with people. That's something I'm going to now do a bit more successfully. Because I'm no longer limited by time as such. So I want to do some more convoys with people, play some more games. I know Farming Sim's a game I really want to get back into. But I've been limited on time in that one. So if you want to do a collaboration, get in touch. Now, Mr. Arvigo, you can do this. This is something else I love in here. You've got 3 arrows above the road. That actually signifies that it's actually a smart motorway. So the actual hard shoulder becomes a lane. They're starting to do that in the UK now. So you're starting to roll that out a lot more. Where do I need to go here? I don't need to turn off here yet. So the next one. Oh yeah, it goes down to a single lane, yeah. Oh, this is tight. Apologies if you can hear my steering wheel banging around. Because the settings have all changed on my steering wheel. The force feedback settings have changed, and now I can't get it right. Like, it's really smooth, and it jitters around a lot when you turn it. I don't know why. I'll look into it. I have to copy off the settings from the other profile, the multiplayer profile. That's correct. That's got some acknowledged resistance to it. this one hasn't. This one's all bumpy and smooth and horrible. Another thing I'm gonna launch is, I want to be able to talk to people. That's one thing I want to do is have like a little, almost like a chat room sort of thing. I wanted to have like almost like a WhatsApp group sort of thing, but didn't want to give away my personal number if it's for security reasons. So I'm actually gonna launch a Discord server. Some people have been telling me about it, and what is the speed limit? 50. Let's slow it down a bit. Some other people looked into it for me as well, and realised that it's actually free. It's free to have, you know, as many as you want. There's no limits to what you can do on it. I don't know what the experience of having one is, or how hard it is to use, or anything like that. I'm completely new to it. Oh, sorry, I apologize. I've used it once when I was talking to the developers of Pokemon Apex. That's a game we've got to go back to and visit. See how that's developing on. Wonder if that's been DMCA'd yet. Be very surprised if it hasn't. Yeah, we've got to go. I'm going to do a separate video on Discord, so I'll explain it, show it, and what it is, and where to go to join, and all that sort of thing. Okay, so I said 90, so it should be able to do 90 now. Yeah, that'd be a thing we'll get up, we'll all chill, have a nice chat. Because one thing we'll do is arrange more convoys on a Sunday sort of thing. So when I'm on here, playing multiplayer, I want people to come on and do some convoys with me, and it's not always the easiest to do it in a video, because not everybody watches the video, and a lot of people miss out, and a lot of people moan, saying, you know, you never said anything, yada yada yada, you get the drift. But I think there's a function. Going right here, don't want to do that. I think there's a function on Discord to actually send a message, a private message, to everyone at the same time. It should be very handy, just so you can get the message across to everybody, what's going on, what's happening. Like, I'm not going to spam it, I won't spam it, guys. I won't, you know, like, keep bothering everyone on it. Just when there's like a convoy and some people are interested, I shall send out a little friendly reminder. Right, this is the junction for Ishimui then, I believe. Yeah, so we're about to get on the port. Oh, there goes the old steering wheel again. I don't think I've ever been into Ishimui then with the old pro module, so I don't know what that looks like. Let's have a little look at what it is. A sip of drink. I did a live stream last night, and that was actually quite a popular live stream. Actually, quite a few people watched it. And I was talking a lot. I think it's one of the most talkative live streams I've done. I was really killing my voice. Like last night, after I finished, I went downstairs and I struggled to talk. It was really sore throat. Sort of my own fault, I didn't have a bloody drink. is Muidel. Sigtel speed limit. Trying to save as much money as possible, trying not to get any speeding tickets. Ain't done much to it. I don't think I made anything to it. Still looks the same, but pretty basic. Right, let's go to port and then get over to Newcastle. And ta-da, just like that, my jumper disappears as well. Ha! Love editing. Love editing! It's like magic. Things disappear. Right, let's kick on. What time of day is it? Nice and see. Nice and see? Nice and clear is what I was meant to say. Cool. Right, let's go. Let's see what they've done in the north of the UK. It's in quite a bit of the south, it's not in the north. Oh, left hand side. That's something I forgot to do actually. I was meant to put the live stream from yesterday, I was meant to go live. I forgot to do that. Have to do that as well. Where's all the traffic gone? There it is. Yeah, loads of traffic just stuck on the roundabout now, are we? Let's go. Cut people out. Oh, hold on, what the hell am I going? I was not paying attention at all to what the map was. I think I was thinking this was like Harwich or somewhere where there's like two roundabouts. Apologies, I was not with that on that one. Okay, first proper cock up of the day. First proper cock up of the new series. That's a grand start. Come on, Mr. Jaguar. Cut this guy up. Come on, son, keep moving. Speed limit, let's go. So some new games that I'm gonna wanna start streaming / doing some videos on. There's gonna be some coming out, well, some out now that I want to do. The top of my list, one of the games at the top of my list, or it's not a specific game, but it's a type of game, right at the top of my list, is a game with a good story to it, that I could do like a multi-part series on. For anybody who watched the Life is Strange series, which I had a lot of fun on, that is the sort of thing I'm going for. I want something with a good story, something that will be gripping, and that will keep people entertained, even if I don't talk over it. Well, most people will be entertained if I don't talk over certain videos. One game that I've got shortlisted for that is Horizon Zero Dawn. That I will hopefully get in the next couple of months. The only thing is, that's on the old PlayStation. So I'll need to get some bits and bobs to... Got the PlayStation down in the living room. That's where I want it to stay. For when we have people around, we can have like party games on there and do certain things on there. So I want to leave that downstairs. Plus, I don't want to clutter it up here. I've got loads of room in here, but I don't want things that don't need to be up here. So I'm going to look into getting that PlayStation TV box that allows you to stream the gameplay up to another room, to another TV. So that is something I'm going to do. Put it to the TV. And I do have a Elgato capture card that, you know, it was one of the things I first ever got when I started YouTube. Because I was recording, I was going to start recording Destiny videos, and I was recording GTA 5 videos as well off PlayStation 4. But I do want to bring back the PS4 as well, because that was. I did really enjoy it, but it's sort of been dead because I've been on the PC so much. But I want to sort of balance it out. I want to go on the PC, PlayStation 4 a bit more. The other reason is because there's a lot of games that have come out that I've missed and not played because I haven't been on the console. Like this Horizon Zero Dawn, I wanted to get it. But because I haven't been on the PlayStation so far, it's sort of been... it's not helped my cause at all, because I haven't been playing it enough to warrant getting the PlayStation Plus, so I haven't been able to do any sort of multiplayer. So I want to get the new Call of Duty as well, the remastered one, because all my friends in that one, I want to play it with them. Yeah, the PlayStation Plus thing has died off, so I haven't got any multiplayer access at all, and I haven't got any of my... I had loads of perks with all that, you know, like downloading one game for each console. I never got it. It's annoying me a bit that I haven't used it as much. But I do want to bring it back. I want to bring it back to the channel as well, because there's quite a few games on there that would look very good on this channel. Story-based ones as well. Because there's also... what else has that come out recently? That was just looked pretty good. There was Final Fantasy as well. Final Fantasy 15, 14, whichever one they're up to now. That come out, I want to play that, but that's a PlayStation exclusive. Or was it Xbox as well? No, Final Fantasy's always been on PlayStation, I believe. Yeah, I wanted to get that and never did. I couldn't warrant it because I didn't know if I'd still stick on the PlayStation, but I'm now in the mindset that I do want to stick on the PlayStation. So, yeah. Oh, slow down. Plus, I did make some really good friends on PlayStation, and I'll just sort of let them die off at the moment. Yeah, so PlayStation will be back. I just need to get get another PlayStation Plus membership, get the game, and get the PlayStation TV streaming box. So That's going to be about just over £100 just to be able to get back up on my PlayStation. Not a cheap venture. I was looking at the Nintendo Switch. You know, as always nowadays, everyone and everything scrutinizes everything about a console until its actual release date. And as they done, there was no different with the Nintendo Switch. If anything, it was more scrutinized because of it being Nintendo. Nintendo are heavily scrutinized because they don't exactly make a console that keeps up to date with latest technology and competes with the big boys, so PlayStation and Xbox. Oh, hello. Got alarms going off. I'll leave that for a second. I can't drive and sort out my phone at the same time. Let's have a crack at it. Do not use your phone and drive. It's highly illegal. Alright, they're turned off. They ain't gonna go off anymore. They're my alarms to make sure I get up and record. Yeah, so the Nintendo Switch has been heavily scrutinized, and when it actually released what the design was going to be and what it was all about, people were already wondering, you know, well, how are they going to have the HD sort of quality in a handheld thing? You can't have that sort of power on a handheld and put it to a TV as well and all, you know. Kendall? What the hell's Kendall? I don't know the quality of. I've never. The only like proper reviews I've heard so far is of Nintendo Switch being used with Zelda Breath of the Wild. Come on, little love, Vico, keep going. And there's not been huge reviews of the Switch just yet, I don't think. I haven't heard anybody say it's really crap, but I haven't heard anybody say it's really brilliant. Zelda Breath of the world the reviews for that have been, you know, they're saying it could be one of the best games ever made, that sort of level, which is really good. I've been really considering whether to get a Switch because of that game. I love the Zelda games. The last proper one I played was trying to think now. No, the last one I played was the last biggest one on the Wii. Oh, what was it? Twilight Princess, that was it. The last one I played was Twilight Princess. That was still a fantastic game. That weren't the best one. The best one I played was Wind Waker. That one, I have been looking to get the HD remastered version on the Wii U. But it's always been a bit too pricey. I haven't been able to find it at a decent price yet. But if I can get that back, I'll play that on the channel. No problem at all. I will play that on the channel. Because that was a fantastic game. The map was breathtaking. The artwork was fantastic. The cartoony sort of effect, it worked really well. And it was smooth as well at the time. That when you kill a monster, it puffs in the smoke, and the motion of the smoke. I love that for some reason. That was. Call me sadistic, but killing monsters felt really. What's the word I'm looking for? Satisfying. It was really satisfying to kill things just to get that puff of smoke. Was it on 50 or 60? I think that's 60. If I can get that at a cheap price, that would definitely be on the channel. But I know that story, that's the only thing. But it's still a good story. I remember playing it on the original. What was that one that was on the. was the GameCube, wasn't it? I think it was on. I'm sure it was the GameCube. It's getting night time. And yeah, it was brilliant on them back then without HD graphics. They weren't in 1080p. Yeah, for the old SCART lead. That was fantastic, absolutely fantastic. I just want to see it in HD now, actually. I've seen a video of it, someone started doing a video of it on an HD remaster one. And that looked gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. I think because of the house and everything, I sort of forgot about it. I sort of put it to the side and said, don't worry about it too much, you know, you can't really afford it. But now, I'm going to have to look into it again. Hopefully the price has dropped now that the Switch is out. I don't know if anyone can help me out, I don't know if anyone knows, is the Switch compatible with Wii U games? You know, is it backwards compatible? Because I know you can get Wii games on the Wii U. I don't know if it'll go over to the new console. I haven't really looked at the proper specs of the Switch, but I know, I'm pretty sure it can do 4K. Can it do 4K? I've heard somewhere it can do 4K. Oh, so everybody get on the old ferry over to the Isle of Wight. No, Isle of Man, sorry, this one, isn't it? This is the one with low speed limits. Well, no speed limits for a car, I don't know about a truck. I would have thought there'd be speed limits for trucks. Traffic? I can't see any traffic. Oh, there is traffic going down there. There's a tanker behind me. Straight in. That bump? Oh, that's not a bump. Right, let's get on the old boat. Head over to Douglas. Okay, so it's actually where we're going to. Let's finish off this coffee. It was a powdery. Oh, hello. Dinky little fairy. This is a dinky little ferry. Can barely fit one truck in there. Cool, right, so we should about to discover Douglas. Let's just have a look at the map here quickly, whilst we're here. Okay, so there's too far. Two towns here. I've got Douglas here on the left. Okay, so the road ends there. That'd be interesting. And there's one up at Ramsey. And you can kind of have a garage here as well. That's pretty fucking good. Is that a garage and a workshop there as well? By the looks of that. You might put both on here at the same time. Let's drive. Just have a look. I want to look more at this. Let's see it firsthand. I'm assuming, I think Isle of Man's still driving on the left. Expecting tight little roads on here. So far, so good. Alright, so you get up here, the road ends. Sort of like a little industrial park. Rumble strips? Okay, alright, so we'll follow this round. Okay, I like it when it goes off the map. So yeah, it looks like just like a ferry port. Over there. Ah, there it is. I like this. I like this a lot. There it is. Mazets. Or is it one way in, one way out? No. I think that's just where it tells you to come out. So you have to turn left. I'll tell you what though, despite all this detail we've got here, I'm still getting 60 FPS. I didn't get that on the old Pro mods. That'll do. I like the seagulls, by the way, out the window. Yeah, that's quite good. Alright, sure, that's all we got. We made 10 grand on that. 10 and a half grand. That's not bad. It's pretty good. We've got time for another short one if we can do. Let's have a little look. Wick. Oh, no, hold on. We need to kick from here, don't we? That's going back on ourselves. Let's go and have a rest. Let's try and reset the jobs. See if we can find another shorter one that goes just over to the UK, back over to the mainland UK. I think there should be a rest stop over at the fuel station, I hope. Do I need fuel? No, I don't need fuel. I think I'm going to sneak into the field just to discover it. There's actually two fuel spots on here. I don't see why you need two. Parking. Do you reckon there's a rest stop in here they can put it on the map? Or is this just car parking? I think this is just car parking, isn't it? Can I get round at the end? Oh no! Oh no, I think I fucked myself over here! I need two cars. I've got two car slot. Ah, I've dipped myself over. I'm not going to get through them one gaps. Okay, so if you're ever playing this game, going down there's a bad idea. Or playing this mod, sorry. Okay, so there's a sleeping point on the port. Let's just head under the port, back under the port, and we'll sleep down there. It's actually down here, down the side. Is it down the end? Oh, it's a strange place to have a rest stop. Okay, it actually says I'm on it now. I'm gonna guess that it's just behind these trucks here. Okay, I should be just on it here. So, engine off. There we go. 1 o'clock in the afternoon, turn the lights off. Let's go and see. Actually, no, I can do it from here, can't I? Job market, freight markets, Aarhus, Rotterdam or Amsterdam. How about that one? No. Should we take a drive at the Ramsey? Let's see. Oops, wrong button. Let's discover. Oh. No, let's go there because then we can get to that place as well. Let's also go here at the same time. And we discover them places in. Yeah, the other man, from what I understand, has no speed limits for a car. A truck might be different. This is where the Isle of Man TT is held. One of the most dangerous road races in the world. Because it's all done on motorbikes. There's not a lot of protection on motorbikes. Okay, so speed limits on here, so I'm assuming the speed limits are possibly in like urban areas. Just go left and discover this place down here. Yeah, I think there's a repair center here as well. Yeah, there is. So I discovered this. It's not ours, you ain't bought it, but we discovered it. Let him go. Come on, Mr. Ivigo, Mr. Ivigo, buddy. Hey, Ivigo, friend! Going to discover Ramsey. I think we'll discover Ramsey, then I'll call it a day. It's not been a bad first video back. So yeah, speed limit's gone now. So I assume it's the same for a truck, but I wouldn't have thought so. I would have thought you still have some sort of legal limit for a truck. I know you've got like the fitted speed limit. But I would have thought it'd be some sort of legal limit for a truck. You're not gonna, don't exactly going to take in your 44 ton truck for a quick spin round the rural areas, do you? Right, we've discovered Ramsey now. So what we got is a farm, is it? Is it this? Yeah, it is this. Okay, yeah. The icon's seen a little bit further down the road. Let's just put on here. So yeah, it's like a little farm. So can we get any jobs from here quickly? Are there any decent jobs we can do for next time? Brussels, Herning, Flesenberg. So Brussels is the most expensive one. So we can't do this trade, it's not a bad one. And also takes us through Hull, sorry, not Grimsby. Yeah, Grimsby's down there. So we can go through Hull. And then make our way down into Belgium. So let's select this one and put, and we'll connect the trailer now, which I think is just here, isn't it? Is it this one? No. Oh, we've got to pick it, and we've got to pick the trailer first. That's a bit strange. The thing isn't by the door, but I like change. Change is good. Right, so we're looking for this one, weren't we? So, could we change the start of the trailer? Wind cannon or promo? Let's stick with the wind cannon one. I like the wind cannon. It's more realistic. Take job. 22 tons. That's going to be an interesting load as well to take. I remember I need to press T on this. Right, so let's leave that there. We don't need to go anywhere with it. Let's put the handbrake on. I did. Okay, yeah. So, that is it. Big stretch. Yeah, so as I said, the series is back. This is the first one back. The other videos that are up there now, I'm going to leave them on for a little while longer, maybe the end of today. Actually, no. Because no point saying today, because this video isn't going to be out today. This video will probably be out Wednesday, I think. So this video will be out Wednesday. On that Wednesday, once this video is out, I'll leave it for another couple of hours for people to go back and watch some of the original series. And then after that, I'll delete those original videos, the other series. So, see, this is a series 1.5. We're starting again. Yeah, we're sort of at a similar level to what it was beforehand. I can't remember what level we were at. I think we were at like level 10 last time. We're only at level 4 at the moment. So we've still got some catching up to do, but we're in a good position to do it. We've really got our own truck. We've got the Ovigo, which we were looking for beforehand. We're struggling with, because we had to do a lot of the quick jobs to try and find it. But we have got one now. But yeah, for now, guys, that is it. So I shall talk to you all very soon. Please catch me on the live streams. I'm going to try and do them as many days a week as I can. So keep an eye out. The Discord server will be coming up. I'll do a video on that, explaining what it is, where it is, how to find it, and all that sort of thing. And then we'll go from there. But yeah, thank you very much, guys. Thank you for watching. And I'll just talk to you all very soon. Bye-bye.